Trying to figure out how you sort of put that all together. The two teams are playing each other. We're running the same plays. We're calling out each plays to each other. It was a just workout in some ways of just both of us just let's play against somebody else and let's wait to the film and try and get better. And that's what we learned, to try to get a lot of guys some even minutes and see how they reacted. So some really good things. We still have several young men still that are, what I'm saying is they're close, but they're still processing a little bit slower and they can't make a quick read on something. And we got to drill that in and drill that in. Some of them it's so easy and some of them it takes more time. I loved our defensive numbers at halftime. I hated our offensive numbers. Second half, it's flipped on us. The offenses for both teams were much better because the defense probably wasn't. So we'll learn about the video today. I mean, I am so excited more excited than anybody in this room to get up at about 6 a.m. and watch a whole bunch of video tomorrow. Yeah. So that I can be ready for our 12 o'clock video session because we gotta get better.
So the microphones are on the sides as usual. Bridget's over here, Caroline's over here. Chris, why don't you start us off?
A couple things. Did you get a lot of the looks that you wanted in the first half?
Yeah, you know, that 3-for-15 was, and we had like five like wide open, but we didn't get them. But that's going to happen sometimes. That's why it's important we find other ways to score, that we throw the ball in the post, that we drive the ball better. It's going to be challenging when Zach Irving gets out there. Now that's a whole other component for us we got to put together, but we have to be up, guy in foul trouble. We have to be able to score in other ways than Karras and Derek. And I love the way Duncan played today. Defensively, he played all zone at Williams, so he's just learning to play man-to-man defense really well. But I like what he gave us this offensively.
Patrick told us twice to ask you about timeouts when he had the better of you, and when he left the room, he said.
Oh, did he score out of the timeouts? I didn't look at that. I'm sure that he'll remember that. This stuff will probably not happen again, so he'll probably better remember it.
Steve? Yeah, Patrick said that the handshake at the beginning of the game was kind of a special moment. Can you recall that for us?
Yeah, it was funny. I asked the question to my staff, what is appropriate when you're playing against your son? Is it a hug or is it a handshake early? Because I didn't think that there's not, you know, I should have asked. Jim Harbaugh actually texted me today and said, enjoy the moment. And I said, I know this is your territory here. But I should have asked him, so what do you do before? Is it a hit? Is it a handshake or a hug? I think I should have did both, but it was a little different. But I just tried to talk about it. You know, they were missing a really good player too, and then their number three there had a great kick.
And then during the game, just looking down there and seeing them, did you have a moment like that?
No, I had no moments like that. I was trying to get my team to play better. I was trying to get my team to play better. So that's that's going to be an issue for me forever. Kathleen could have been on the other bench. I would have been trying to get my team to play better.
Noah? John, I guess the first game out there with the shorter shot clock, how did you think your guys?
Yeah, there was a couple times I really noticed it. We got to get something going. I think there's times in our offense that we'll take an extra dribble, we'll take an extra minute to set up that we can't do. I think we got to shorten down that dead time so that we can really get into things quicker and then read it and cut better. But we're still working on that comfort of having that 30 seconds, so 35 seconds, but I think we got rushed a couple of times.
Karras said, I guess you guys have practiced at times with 25 seconds.
Yeah, we did that earlier in the year. You know, we stopped doing that in the last couple of weeks. We might have to go back to that. Because there's 3 seconds sometimes that it takes us to get into something that we had the luxury to do before we don't have it. We got to pop that ball and move and drive it.
Swing over to Brendan.
I'm sure this will be kind of a theme in early games, but all these different lineups and rotations that you can put together, all these different pieces. Where are you on that right now? Is it just fully kind of just testing orders?
Yeah, exploring and trying to figure it out. I mean, really, what are we going to do over that right now? When Zach, hopefully Zach's going to be back real soon. What are we going to do when Zach comes back? That's what he said today. DJ and Cam are going to split those 40 over there, right? And then we're going to make sure Mo got in there. And then we're going to split the other side. But what we do have, as you may have noticed today, if you get lost in a defensive assignment, you get a blow by, take a seat, and we have that luxury that we haven't had before.
Are there times where you like go into a practice or an instance like tonight where it's, I want to see those two on the floor together and see how they play off each other? How does that work?
Yeah, we're trying to figure that out right now. What groups, like this year, yesterday we had 9 groups together, and I tried to manipulate the lineup a little bit to see what I wanted to see. But we, this is a puzzle right now. And while I'm not puzzled, I'm extremely interested in what we do. But there's a lot of pieces of this puzzle we still got to figure out. And I know after 4 weeks, I think we should. No, we're not close.
Mark, first time you've seen Karis and Derek in a real game in a long time. Did you appreciate that?
I thought they really played well. They missed a couple of defensive assignments, which they got to be defensive shutdown guys right now. I mean, they got to shut people down. And that's got to be the mentality. But, you know, in the past couple of years, we didn't have that luxury. And now, last year I would have gone, if one of them had a blow-by, I wouldn't have gone to Muhammad on the bench against New Jersey Tech because he wasn't ready to do it either. Now guys like that are a little bit better. So I will not have a quick hook on offense. I will have, unless they blow up a timeout play. But I will not, defensively, we got to be holding accountable. But to have them together is good. They can be elite defenders, I think. But that's got to be their mentality.
Karis had that flurry in the second half there, that little burst of points. I mean, is that something that you guys were missing that almost from anyone? Aubrey had a couple moments, but not too much last year.
Yeah, it is really important that he just got out there and played. And I did want to give him significant minutes. I wanted to give him as many minutes as I had, Derek and Spike. I tried to get Spike in as much. Those guys have been so out of it that they need to play in a real game, and they'll admit that's a different situation.
Brent?
Patrick says, it might be a good idea for you guys to.
Where'd you interview him? At, like Connor O'Neill's or something?
Right there.
I know that. Sorry, you had inside information.
Might put out the offer for you now to come open up their facility next year. What do you think?
That will not be happening. For sure. We are just going to, we're going to do what we do. Like I said, this is probably a one-time thing, and we did it just to repay LeMoyne and get Patrick off to a good start and recreate a human interest story for you.
Anything else for Coach? All right, thanks, guys.
Thanks.